Scott King joining us now from NHL.com amidst a very raucous crowd there, apparently, at the United Center. And, Scott, the Hawks have won five straight, and all of a sudden, they're just 3 points out of a wild card spot. Even though some of the teams in the West are cold, is it a little too late for Chicago right now?
It's not, EJ. You look now, 3 points out, yeah, ahead of tonight's game against the Canucks. But if they beat the Canucks, then St. Louis loses in Tampa, they're just 1 point out. So you look at a couple months ago, you know, Crawford goes down again. They're learning new coach's system. You're getting some new players. You wouldn't have thought this was possible just a little bit ago. And now here we are. It's almost a miracle.
Yeah, and it has been a tough season for the Hawks so far, but I would think winning five in a row, the mood must be much better. I would think these guys think they can get there.
Look, I think they're incredibly motivated. They're checking the standings just like us, just like the fans. And the coaches have said they are, too. They know they're close. They know things are working. You know, you don't get a five-game winning streak and beating some of the teams you have, like the Capitals, like the Islanders, in that streak without playing some really good hockey. There's a lot of consistency, and they're really happy right now.
With the winning streak has come some consistency. How have the Hawks been able to keep the momentum rolling? Because it didn't seem like there was much of that consistency earlier in the season.
Well, it's all started with their offense, and they've gotten a big confidence boost from the power play. They're converting 40% of their power plays since Christmas, and that's amazing. So, you know, you're getting a couple goals from there, sometimes a game. And then that's translating into their five-on-five hockey. They're getting a lot of confidence in their offense in general, and then they're getting contributions from defense. Their units are a lot more reliable than they were at the beginning of the season. And look, you don't have Corey Crawford right now, but Colin Dealey and Cam Ward are doing more than their fair share of keeping this team in every game.
All right, trade deadline coming up a few short weeks away. What might we expect from the general manager, Stan Bowman?
I don't know if you should expect anything if they're still winning. I mean, 6 games ago, if you asked me, I'd say, yeah, you know, they could use a top forward. They could use a top D-man, maybe some depth scoring. But right now, they're winning. And, you know, those guys who might have been enticing before, like Assad, like Anisimov, you're going to need them right now because they're playing well. Everyone's playing well. And you're not going to be able to get Keith or Seabrook off the books right now or maybe in the future if they're not willing to waive their no-trade clauses.
All right, I got to ask you, there's a lot of noise at the United Center. I know the Hawks and the Canucks have not started yet, so what's going on there?
Hey, look, you know, I think this Pee Wee team is just 3 points out of a wild card spot the way the way things are going on here. I'm not sure, EJ.
Well, it's a raucous crowd. We're pulling back a little bit, and we see some of the folks around you there. So kids hockey at the United Center.
You won't floss right now, Scott. You won't
floss?
Yeah. No, he's not going to do any dancing. Scott, thanks for your time, buddy.